Hey, how is everybody doing? This is Lake Effect Radio. That's lakeeffectradio.org/studio. And today you are a lucky guest to be here with us while we're interviewing the great Davey Squires here in the building, everybody.
Hello.
All right.
Thank you.
And he's coming
here,
all the way
I got
out
you
here.
Better.
Hey, that's what I'm talking about. So that's the great thing about technology. So we got Davey Squires here, and he's a musician, pianist, keyboardist. He's out here from Akron, and he's going to, you know, do an interview with us today, play a little live music for us, and give us a little breakdown about his band, where he's from, and some of the things he's interested in. So I'm going to start it off with just a quick couple questions, Davey. Like, where does the name Davey Squires come from?
I was born David Squires, but people just started calling me Davey. I guess it's a variation of David or Dave or whatever, but people just call me Davey, and, you know, Squires is my actual name, but that's what people call me. That's my name.
Well, it's actually a very cool name.
That's my name.
You know, you're blessed. Unlike people like me who have a weird name, you know, people got to give me names. You know, Davey Squires actually sounds good, but...
What's your name?
My name? Oh, man, I don't want to get it. But what we will do is, what I wanted to ask you was, like, I was Googling you up, like I was telling you earlier, and I was trying to figure out, like, who is Davey Squires? Because, honestly, you sound famous.
Yeah.
And I mentioned a couple people, like, yeah, I'm about to interview Davey Squires. Even him, he was like, oh, he might be rich. We're about to get signed.
I'm just some guy.
None of us are rich here, man.
That's what I thought.
Oh, Jordan, I was like, man.
I was like, ooh, I got to get some tips off him. See what he's doing.
I try my best.
Got to figure it out. So, yeah, sure. I was trying to figure out, David. I was looking up your name and everything, trying to figure out what kind of music, because I want to have a little background before we did the interview. And I seen the picture that I seen online, which you obviously already said was old.
Oh, yeah.
And I started to look at you walking in the door. Yeah. You're a very large man in the picture. And, you know, the picture that was online, you know, it looked like a little kind of smaller dweeb looking guy with short hair.
That was like high school me.
Uh-oh. Yeah. So he made a transformation.
Yeah.
All right.
I evolved.
So how long have you been doing music? It seems like you've been doing this for a while because you definitely transformed. So.
Well, I started doing concert band in fifth grade. That's like where that's the first like time I started playing music, and I was a percussionist in concert band, like middle school concert band.
Right.
And I kept doing that all throughout high school, and then I think my junior year of high school, I started doing choirs and show choir stuff, so I started singing too. And you don't really see that many drummers who also sing.
Right.
So it's kind of like a
hot
come on.
Because it's kind of hard to sing and drum at the same time. Oh, man.
I've had to do that multiple times for bands I've been in. Yeah, I've had to do backup vocals and stuff. And even still at school, I go to school at Kent State Stark down in North Canton. And I still, you know, play drums and sing at the same time.
Boom, dum, dum,
yeah. Oh, yeah.
I'm trying to kick it.
And, like, from there, I took. I'm a music technology major too.
Wow!
So nice. I have to do piano classes and whatnot.
Right.
And so,
for people that don't know, not to cut you off, music class is not easy.
Yeah.
And if you come to Lakeland take a music class, you better get on there and check some reviews, because I promise you, you're gonna go into a music class here thinking it's gonna be sweet, and next thing you know, you're gonna get your grade and be going down to counseling and crying.
Yeah.
So please make sure if you get into music, it's not an easy field, because you have to learn the techniques. You know. Mm-hmm.
Oh yeah.
Is that something that you had to learn, like the techniques and the classics and all the different?
Yeah. Well, since I was already trained, prior to college, I see a lot of people come into college, and because they want to be like music producers and audio recording people, and they come in with no like theory experience.
Right,
it's like,
right.
Holy crap. It's
like a culture shock.
Yeah. There's a lot more that goes into music than what you see on, you know, MTV whatever, you know?
Right.
Yeah. And, you know, from there I started playing piano and keyboard stuff. And, when I got to Kent State Stark, I joined a band called Land of Panda. They play all around now. They're getting pretty big in the Akron and even Cleveland music scene. Yeah, they
Land of Panda.
Mm-hmm.
Where'd they get that name from?
Oh, I just like pandas.
Oh, you guys created that? You created
Yeah.
Those?
Oh, yeah.
Okay.
we came up with it, and it was like.
Not including the drum that actually has the panda on the front of it.
Man, I gotta check that out.
Many people seen that last spring.
Yeah, I have pictures of it. I can show you.
So what happened? Did you guys like take a break? You had a fight, a disagreement, a drunken brawl, or what? What kept you guys to not working together?
Well, they're still playing.
Okay.
Just with different drummers and stuff. For me personally, we were playing 2-3 shows a week. And
exhausted.
Going to school and going to work. And after me personally, I was doing it for like a year straight. And
living
it's
on
like,
ramen noodles and coffee beans.
Yeah. And like after after that, it's kind of like, well,
hey.
I'm tired.
Right. Yeah. I want to take a nap.
It's
right
been
now.
Fun, but I got to run.
Yeah. But I don't know. I've personally been drawn to more acoustic music.
Right.
And coffee shop style. I listen to a lot of John Mayer, a lot of Grateful Dead acoustic stuff.
Right,
and
right.
A lot of older Beatles acoustic,
oh,
too.
Oh, he's taking it back.
Yeah.
Well, you got to start the basics. If you want to learn anything about what the great music, I feel like if you want to make great music, you got to kind of go off of what, you know what I mean?
Oh, yeah. You're past people.
Right,
you know?
Yeah. Yeah. I mean, that's actually one of the classes I was taking, the popular music class. I thought it was just going to be about, you know, the music we listen to today, but...
Oh, yeah.
I didn't realize that the music that we make today, like the coffee shop music, the John Myers, if people like that, all of it is just an origination of genre of music that was called, like, just rock, like, just music.
Yeah.
They didn't even have a name for it. And everybody, all races, everything, they all sang the same kind of music, but then they split it up to rock, country, R&B.
Yeah.
Like, they even asked B.B. King, like, what... You know, you're a R&B. He's like, I'm not a rhythm and blues singer. I'm singing country.
Yeah.
But, I mean, it's all formulated from the same. So do you feel like the path that you're taking with your music and, like, the, let me take it back. What kind of sound do you want people to hear when they listen to your music?
I want them to hear kind of a singer-songwriter, folky type deal with some pop put in there.
Right.
Which is kind of funny because Land of Panda was... funk, our three main genres, funk, punk, and reggae.
Right.
Which is totally different from what you're going to hear today.
Okay.
And being I love drumming reggae and drumming funk. The drum patterns are so unique and fun to do.
Yeah.
It's like, it's really fun. But then going from that to this, it's like night and day.
Different worlds.
It's different. And I'm singing and doing keyboards, which is totally different from drumming. And
you went from Jamie Foxx to... But I mean, I guess is there anything that
I got a question though for you. So like what's one way somebody who wants to come up from what like kind of what you're doing, like making connections, like, you know, like good networking skills, what's a good way to handle that situation? And what's, like, how have you handled it over the course of years? You know, you've been doing music and stuff.
For me personally in the area, it's always helpful to join a band and have, you know, you have your friends. And then you can reach out from there. Then you have multiple people for your band reaching out.
Right.
That's how it happened for me personally.
Okay.
But if you can't do that, I would totally get into open mics. If you're like a singer-songwriter,
there's
a ton of those going on, especially in Kent, up here in Akron.
What's the environment like out there?
In Kent? I went to this a couple weeks ago. Every week they do an open mic at a place called The Outpost, where they have usually hard rock and metal bands, but they have, they've been doing a lot of acoustic stuff there too.
Right.
But they do one every week. I think they're the only ones in Kent.
What about the Cleveland area? Just Menor, you know, the area around here in Curland, for anybody that wants to go to an open mic.
Oh, I'm not sure. Well,
this kind of outside your region, huh?
Yeah.
Well, we need to look into that.
Yeah. Downtown Willoughby has many places.
Oh, really? That's right. Willoughby.
Or here in area, they do different shows.
Yeah.
Not including, like, you right now. Rib Cook-Off.
What?
Willoughby.
Yeah, that sounds about it.
They look for, actually, people to play down there. Like, AJ in the Woods, that's over, like, Cleveland side. They were going to play there, but that storm decided to come in.
Uh-oh.
So,
clean that clock.
Yeah,
rain on their parade.
Oh, especially with lightning and that, yeah.
Yeah. That's unsafe.
So, that's oh, especially because many of those stages, there's not a cover over top of them. So,
oh yeah, talk about talk about rain coming down.
All that equipment,
man.
Oh yeah.
So, ooh, what is this beautiful piece of machinery you have right here?
This is a keyboard.
This is a keyboard. And what type of keyboard is it? And like, how long have you used it? What do you do with it?
Well, I use different. There's a electric piano setting I like on here. That's a really chill, like a really chill. There's a composite piano that I have on right now that I like to use for just like, you know, classical stuff too.
Right.
But I bought it off of. I was looking for a new one on Facebook because my old one was terrible. But I forget who I bought it from. But it was some guy who lived in like the hood.
Right. And you know, you get everything good in the hood.
It was
hey man, take this for $5.
It was like,
man, how did you carry this all the way up the street, man?
He helped me. Right. You go around the roundabout.
And then you got a midget just pop out the bushes like, hey man, just give me the $5 or not.
But I got the deals.
So you really just bought this in the hood, and now you're about to make millions of dollars out of this machine, right?
I'm hoping to get a new one before. Casio is a good keyboard brand. It's like, but I could definitely get a better one, but that costs money. So
right,
but it's really good for what it's for.
And what do you do? Is this when you perform it live? Do you take this up there with you, or do you they have something they already have with them?
Sometimes they have like an acoustic piano, like an old timey one. I know a place in Wadsworth I do open mics at called Sonnets. They have this old timey honky tonk piano that's like from late 1800s.
Woo.
And it still works.
You know, some people got killed over those tunes.
Yeah. I don't know how long it's been there though, but it still works, and it's a little bit detuned, but it's still like,
it's good enough.
Yeah, as long as you don't play with anybody else,
right?
It's fine.
Don't mix them sounds up. You're gonna hear pitches unless you're tone deaf. Then you could go in there and rickety rack all day long. So what?
We should get them into playing. Yeah. You know what that keyboard or what it can do.
Yeah,
that would be a good segue in a way.
Let's do that. Yeah. Let's hear some of this stuff.
Hey, right, but real quick, before you start, I just want to know. I know you've been doing this for a long time, but I know it's probably. I know it's sometimes stuff happens. Yeah. How do you handle a mistake like during just like?
Oh yeah, that's a good question.
How do you handle that?
Like note wise or?
Yeah, like you know if you. I know you jamming, you doing your thing, but you like, oh, I think I just the raw. That was all right.
I usually act like it didn't happen and you just like, move on.
Right.
Okay. Just like, yep, just keep jamming and
okay,
keep going.
Okay.
They don't know the song.
They don't know the song. Yeah, you're right. Okay.
That's a good question, though, because I just freeze up. If I'm performing and I mess up, I just like, I get so shocked.
Just like hit the wrong chord or something.
Yeah.
Just hope it. Keep going.
I just like play the keys and my fingers are stopping. I'll be like, okay, magical keys.
Be like, what? That didn't happen.
Easy money. Going. So what is something that you can do first right now? Like, what can we do so we can hear kind of what you...
I can play one of the first songs I've written before.
How's that sound?
Yeah.
All right. It's sounds good.
It didn't mean completely good. Cut you off.
Right.
But yeah.
There we go. All right. So this one is called True Blue. It's a song I wrote back, I'd say like 3 years ago, but it's one of the first singer-songwriter type songs that I've ever written, so. Your level's good, sir.
Yeah, to me.
So blue like the heavens. Your eyes so blue like the sky. Stay the way you've always been portrayed. You never look so true, so blue. Stay the way you've always been portrayed. You never look so true, so blue. Thank you.
say the way you've always been portrayed. You never look so true, so blue. Stay the way you've always been portrayed. You never look so true, so blue. Stay the way you've always been portrayed. You never look so true, so blue. Stay the way you've always been portrayed. You never look so true, so blue.
Thanks, man. Well, thanks, guys. Oh, yeah.
We got free claps. You guys can save your energy. I know everybody in this building is tired, right? We don't need any help. But do you want my honest opinion, Davey?
Yeah, well. All
right.
Give me it.
So, honestly, man, I think it sucks.
Oh, man.
Oh, jeez. Oh, jeez.
No, I'm just joking.
Oh, man.
I wasn't expecting that, man. I mean, I think that's, I don't know anybody that can. I was just smiling the whole time because I just think anybody that can do two things at once, I can't do two things at once. So anybody that can play the piano and simultaneously sing and the words make sense and they're on pitch and the keys sound good, you're all right in my book. Like, that's good. You know, you might be able to go somewhere. If you believe in yourself, then you know you might be a star. But, yeah, that's absolutely wonderful, man. I mean, that you came up with those lyrics and that you wrote everything yourself.
Oh, yeah. That was all written by me.
Did you know Lakeland got a strict policy on plagiarism? We're going to have to call Lakeland police now.
Oh, I know.
Yeah, you might not be enrolled here, but it'll apply to you.
Yes. They had a Lakeland police up here immediately.
They're outside the window.
Right. So
nice listen, knowing you.
Man, I'm telling you, they'll be ushering him out so quick. Man, but
I'd be hopping out the window.
how long is the process? What is the process for you to create something like that?
That took about 40 minutes to make for me. Yeah,
40 minutes.
It was very easy to make, but it I'm a jamming type of person. I go to, you know, I have a ton of friends that love to jam, and they're like, "Hey, come over, bring your keys, bring your drum set."
So that could just come out in a session.
Yeah, and I love just going into a practice room and just sitting on a keyboard for like 40 minutes straight, just coming out with chords and stuff. That's how I came up with that. And it's just you start playing.
I know somebody was mad at you while you was trying to figure out.
But that's what I do at my coffee shop shows. Like I do random chords. Like I just start doing random chords, and it's like I just start doing stuff off of it.
But
start improv.
Top then. Let's this improv, man. We want to make this
all right.
Interesting.
Okay.
Oh God.
All right, here we go.
Want to adjust those vocals.
Can I do just an instrumental for you guys? An improv instrumental. This one's kind of jazzy too. I love jazz, so.
Me too. Okay, so we're about to improvise here. Davey Squires is on the keyboard instrumental and DJ OPM on the vocals. I was sitting there thinking about you. I was so in love. I was so in love. Blinded by passion and the fury inside of my heart. You were like a dove. You were like a dove, but what the f- What the fudge cake and brownies on top of that whipped cream? It looks so good to me. Yeah. Two cases of fries and some whipped cream on that donut with syrup, baby. I think it's good if you would get a little nastier. I'm trying to do this one more time. I'll sit you back in the ocean, baby. I'll take you back to the ocean. Get Barry White voice on you real quick, love. I'll take you back to the moon and stars, baby. Yeah, black butterflies, little kids in the ghetto. Matt Murray and Pathfinders, we got a meeting this Friday, yeah. We got David Squires in the building, yeah. You know he said he was singing in the choir, yeah. Hey, yeah, 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 for Rashad. Yeah. So we'll have a whole session. Like, if you had
that
time.
That was man,
how'd y'all feel about man. That?
It was sort of really improv.
I'm so glad my mic was muted. I was like, what is he doing?
It's easy, huh? So if anybody heard that right now, that was Davey Squire's live performance.
That was like, live improv.
Yeah, I mean, he actually really got down on that. I mean, I'm sweating right now, so I think if we had some time, we would all have been in here like really hot, because I was going to sing for at least 2 hours straight.
Man.
But where did you learn to do that?
That's a long interview.
Oh, man. 2 hours. They better bring some cash up here. They're going to be looking for Davey going to be like, look, we need some money for this interview. Hey, so where did you, how did you learn how to do this? Where did you said you learned from the choir, but like, did anybody ever, like, did your parents pay for instructions? Did you go to Willoughby School of Fine Arts, Akron School of Fine Arts? What happened?
Oh, yeah. I've had many percussion teachers and singing teachers throughout the years, but piano is all self-taught.
Wow.
With the knowledge of theory, like, you know, that you have knowing. To take just right. knowing chords and how they work and how they resolve. It's
so, what is a chord for somebody that might not know?
Should I give a theory lesson? Here we go. So a chord is it can be two or more notes play at the same time, but they get more complex as you add more notes.
Okay.
I can give a whole theory lecture right now.
Well, just give me 2 minute lecture. Give me two chords.
All right. So so an A flat chord is made up of A flat, which is like the root note. And the root note is usually in the name of the chord, and C and E flat. And then if you add more notes, that's called a seventh, because it's the seventh of the scale.
So give us a seventh.
Let's see. There you go.
Ooh, that sounds like almost a church.
Yeah, that gospel music, church music, and jazz music all use seven chords a lot, and nine chords too.
Okay, bust out a nine chord for me. Ooh, yeah, he looked at me kinda, like, yeah, you know,
that's kind of like
everybody know that's Sunday. That bedroom. Do it again. Yeah, baby.
I know. Daniel Caesar uses that a lot. Dude.
Yeah, I'm coming through.
But yeah, that's what chords are.
So what chords do you use? Because I noticed that it seemed like, I mean, I didn't know if Adele was about to bust out. That could have been, you know, who knows? What sound do you guys hear when you hear that?
Man, I definitely hear, I don't know about his sound.
Yeah, his sound.
With the last song that you played.
Yeah.
I like how you, it was like going up and then you like went down.
Yeah.
And then you was like, I like that. That was dope.
So he didn't try to go out of his range, basically. He know where his voice is at.
He know what's going on, so I can't say nothing.
Right. Because if he would have been in here like, we would have had to close the curtain on this. Right. Oh, he got some pipes on him, though. So where did you get the vocal background? So we got the instrumental portion of it. How did you get the, like, to know how to sing? Because, you know, we've all watched American Idol, and we know how horrible people can actually sound.
It's not easy.
Well, you actually got a decent voice, so how did you work on that?
I've had a teacher for 3 years now, and one of my main instruments is singing at Kent State. So I have to do a studio class where I sing in front of people every week.
Really?
Yeah.
Like busting the lungs out?
Well, you have songs to pick from. Like, you pick 5 songs at the beginning of the semester, and right. then those are the songs you can choose to sing in the studio class.
And that's the songs that the teacher sets out a list of, and then you choose from that, or you make your own list?
There's a classical class that they choose the music for you, but I'm in the popular music class right now, which I can pick what music, what
the
songs
class
to sing.
That I actually just said, oh, man. All right, so so you choose 5 songs, and then you go in there and do what with them? Just cover them, basically?
Yeah, put your own twist on them.
So bust up one out, then. Can he bust one out?
Are we allowed to do covers?
Yeah.
Can we do covers? Oh, okay. I can do a John Mayer song right now.
Kill it.
No, not for you now.
Him and those drums.
Badooch. Swear you're right. Some people have lived their lives knowing that, but you find yourself alone like you find yourself before. Like you find yourself alone like you. I forget the words right now. Here, hold on. Hard times let me be. I'm a good man with a good heart. Had a tough time, got a rough start, but I finally learned to let it all go. Now I'm right here, and I'm right now, and I'm hoping, knowing somehow, that my shadow days are over. My shadow days are over now. Remember the chorus. Some troublemaker, and I never meant to harm, but it doesn't mean I didn't make it hard to carry on. Well, it sucks to be honest, and it hurts to be real, but it's great to make some love that I can finally feel. Hard times let me be. I'm a good man with a good heart. Had a tough time, got a rough start, but I finally learned to let it all go. Now I'm right here, and I'm right now, and I'm hoping, knowing somehow, that my shadow days are over. My shadow days are over now. That's basically it. That's
it. Yeah, hey, man. Golly, this man is a man of many talents and gifts, man. I mean, he's blessed beyond blessed. And I mean, I'm just impressed, really, you know. A lot of times you meet people that really, like, they have a love for music, but, like, when they're performing, you don't feel the energy. Because, I mean, I'm exhausted, and it would have been easy for me to go to sleep in here if it was... You're making it sound like a Catholic mass. Now, no offense, but... I mean,
are you
I'm
really
preach
sure?
It, preach it.
Well, he really did. He's doing good. You know what I mean? Like, for somebody that just, you said, started off in the choir and came up from, like, just regular backyard roots and, like, training yourself and everything else. Like, it sounds like something that we could hear. That this could be anybody right now. So, you know, I appreciate you coming up here, blessing us with that, you know, and... this is the first time you came with this new genre, right?
Or, yeah.
Okay, oh, yeah. So, I mean, for us to be able to preview and premiere that, you know, be able to let the audience hear, you let your fans hear, if anybody's paying attention or if anybody goes back and reviews the show, they can see how you upgraded from, you know, when you started off with Landa Panda to this point now. So are you still keeping the same name? Are you going to end up going back with Landa Pandas when you get time? Or how's that going to work?
Well, I might... I've been like jamming with them lately a lot, but I'm kind of booked solo wise
right
at this point. You're like
focusing on Davey Squires.
Yeah, so foreseeable future, I'm just a solo artist for now. But
so is there anybody, like, how can people reach you if they want to get in touch with you, if there's an artist that wants to collaborate with you? You know, how can people get in touch with Davey Squires?
Well, I have a Facebook page. It's just Davey Squires.
All right, so let them know, because I was Googling. I Googled Davey Squires just to let you guys know. And the guy that you see on there
has short hair.
Yes, you're gonna be like, okay, this is Pee Wee Herman.
It's like a 14-year-old me,
right? Like, I mean, Pee Wee Herman. I said Pee Wee Herman, but I didn't like. I meant Justin Timberlake like the Pee Wee Herman outfit on.
Well, you don't have your drums set, so someone has to do it.
Yeah, him and the drums. He's killing the drums right now.
Yeah.
So when are you gonna come back with the drums? Like,
I could just do an interview, just drums. I could just do solos in the studio, just drum solos.
Yeah.
Would that work out?
Yeah, that might work. I mean, I don't know how they're going to feel next door, but...
Just put me in this corner and we'll see how it goes.
Man, try it out. So, you said it's Davy Squires on Facebook. How do you spell it to make sure everybody gets the correct spelling?
D-A-V-E-Y. S-Q-U-I-R-E-S.
All right, and that's for anybody that's below the eighth grade.
Yeah, it's just Squire with an S on it.
That's, I mean, you would just imagine how many people can't spell Squires.
Yeah,
you
I
might get
see
S-K-Y-E-R-E.
Skewers.
Right.
Skewers. The little skewers
like,
right there.
Man.
But I actually just started a website of my own.
Okay, this is your time. This is your platform.
It's actually just DavySquires.com.
Man, how simple can that be?
That's all it is. Yeah. And it has all my pictures and all my music on it, all my solo stuff, and it has some videos of me doing some drum grooves and stuff on it. And also, most recently, I started a radio show up over at Kent. It's called The Squire Show. There's a tab for that on there, too, just like. It's just a tab on there for it. And
nice.
Ready to go.
So who made it?
It's Mondays at 2 p.m.
I have to pay attention to this.
So it's
so Mondays
randomly
2
call in.
Yeah, randomly call in.
Randomly call in during a show here.
Hey, it's me.
To that show.
Two shows just connecting.
Right.
Exactly.
But it's
what could go wrong?
Everything. But it's every. It's. But it's every Monday at 2. BlackSquirrelRadio.com is the website you can listen to it at. There's a link on my website, too. It's like up in the little banner. It's the button with the little acorn on it.
Wow. Okay. You busy right now.
Yeah, I have a ton of... Yeah, that's why I can't be in the banner now.
Acorn? The acorn tab?
Yeah, it's like an acorn.
Yeah, button.
Oh, okay. Acorn button.
Yeah.
That's like their logo. But
yeah, because it's Black Squirrel for a reason.
Oh,
Black Squirrel. This cat has black squirrels out
acorn,
there.
Acorn, Black Squirrel. Yeah. Yeah,
there's squirrels everywhere. Right. It's ridiculous.
Where is this
they
at?
They actually have black squirrels here.
Kirtland? Oh, yeah. Man. Have anybody ever been to the Kirtland or that museum? What's it called? Something right here around the area.
Down
Gunners
the hill?
Point or... Well, they have a thing out here where they exhibit basically the... terrain of Kirtland and like all the wildlife. They have some wild animals. Like, you will not want to be out here after class with your car broke down in Kirtland. You might walk up on like
they have the Holden Arboretum just over there.
So that's what it is. Yeah. It's some Penitentiary Glen.
Oh, yeah.
Okay. Yeah, that. Have you ever been there?
I have not. I've heard of it though.
So what shows are you jamming out? You said you were jamming out in the Kent area, Akron too?
Yeah, I'll be in Akron strike that. I'll be on Friday. I'll be at Mugswig's in Canton, which is a coffee shop. They're awesome there. Their coffee's really good.
Right.
And then I'll be at the High Arts Festival in Akron on Saturday. I'm playing at 5:40 p.m. at Blue Jazz downtown.
So is that a new thing now? Because I remember I was telling you before the show that one of my buddies is starting a coffee shop.
Yeah.
And like he wants people to come in and perform, but he doesn't want that bibbity bop. So is this the new wave? Like people want to hear like softer, more easy on the ears music, and not so much like the
what's bibbity bop?
Like I guess like, anything that has any bass to it and a whole bunch of like
this.
That does have bass in it.
Yeah, that's it right there.
Exactly.
But basically, like you know, the stuff we hear in the day on the radio.
Yeah. A lot of personally at my shows, I do a lot of jazz.
Right.
Which is really relaxing. Whenever I end a show, like I was just at the Root over there in Lakewood, and they were like, "That's so relaxing." Like
right.
I had the hold on.
People trying to relax nowadays. Everybody need rest.
I had the
bust
electric,
it out.
Oh, this is just what it sounds like, guys. But this is like, you know, I play instrumentals on this little patch here, and it's like, it's so relaxing. And after every show, they're like, man.
Wait, I wish we could get a close up on his fingers. You was only touching like 3 keys right there.
Just touching.
And it sounded so beautiful.
No, that's 5 keys.
Do it again. Do it for 2 minutes to see if I can stay awake.
I can't count now.
So, let me see here. You're doing shows. You got the radio show going on.
Yeah.
You're doing the shows. You're doing the solo work. Dave Squires is a busy man right now.
I'm very busy.
And how's your love life looking?
I'm too busy.
Play the drums. Hit. Too oh man, he was supposed to have the drums. Right, there they go.
I accidentally hit something.
I'm too busy for you.
You know, in an interview, you always got to get in people's business. I always wanted to be like Wendy Williams. Make people get mad.
Wendy Williams on me.
Right, like, man, hey, I was Googling you, Davey, and I seen that you cheated on your last girlfriend.
She be all in it, man.
I'm too busy right
now. He says he's too busy. He's just straight focused.
I'm too busy for that. Well, I've been through the ringer a couple times, and, you know, I got to take a break. I got to take a break and do music, do something that I love.
So since you're not in love with anything else but the music, what important figures or what people or what type of jazz would you say motivated you and inspired you? Like, you know, what would you call your music and what inspired you? What artists inspired you?
I listened to a ton of Grateful Dead and Phish, like those jam bands.
Right.
I listened to a good amount of John Mayer. He kind of inspired me to do like a singer-songwriter type deal. But I listened to a lot of different genres and stuff like that.
Before we go, is it possible that he could bust out another song? I was trying to hear one more thing.
Not including you got Tim out here. He actually asked something interesting.
Yeah.
Wow. I don't know if you want to do the song, then we'll go into that.
I might know. Wait. No, say no. Ask it. I want to.
Okay.
Well, let's get Tim in there.
Yeah.
So, would you rather play in front of 3,000 people you don't know and have a clue who you are, or 300 of your closest friends?
Oh. Dang, that's a good question, man.
That's a little deep there.
I started shaking when he said 300,000.
That's not bad. That's not bad.
I know. I need that publicity.
Yeah.
Not even publicity. Oh, he put the timer on this man.
I got bored, you know.
But if it's for the publicity, then the first one. But if it's just for like, if we're having drinks and if I'm drunk at the keyboard,
right,
then it's for friends.
Friends. How many of us have them?
Believe it or not, I would have went with just the second one because I just love the energy from just people who, you know, love and support me, man. Oh, even though you know, it'd be fans or whatever the case might be, but you know, you got 300 of your closest friends.
Yeah,
like,
that's a party.
That's a more party. Than a party. And then they're gonna bring more people anyway.
I want to know what venue it's at, actually.
Right. Yeah. Let me pick first.
Where are we going? Doing this in the park or what are we doing?
So yeah. What did you say? You said you would the first one.
If it's for publicity, then the first one. But if I'm drunk, then...
Don't worry, it's another question for you.
Right.
Is Tom Brady softer than Cristiano Ronaldo?
Uh-oh.
Oh, my gosh.
Golly, he's getting to the nitty-gritty.
Ooh.
Where haven't I heard this from?
And being from Akron, I mean, Canton, I mean, that's like the Football Hall of Fame, so you gotta, like, he's got you under pressure.
Is Tom Brady softer than Cristiano Ronaldo?
I don't watch either of them. I don't watch either of them. I'm indifferent.
Agree.
I like that.
I'm indifferent.
You're indifferent. Like you gotta give us. Okay, give us something.
I don't want. Okay. Let's see here.
We got some more questions. He's over there smiling.
I know. He piling them up.
He sits there and says, "No, that's the correct answer." Is if he doesn't say mute him,
right?
And then he says,
"Because you know that was a setup question from the beginning.
That's a trick question.
You didn't expect to laugh this hard, did you?"
I did not. Well, nah. I don't know.
He thought he was going to come
last
in here
time
and just,
was.
I don't really have much. I don't have expectations.
Right. I'd be telling people, hey, remember the last show? I was telling people to lower your expectations and raise your acceptance. Mm-hmm. Yeah. That was something that I really like, really big on, because I felt like, you know, the less we expect, the less we got to get disappointed.
Exactly.
Correct.
Woo-hoo. I mean, he's got this stuff down packed with these mean voices.
Oh, I got a lot.
Yeah. So let's hear something. I want to hear something.
I think it was about a month ago. It's a really simple song, but I like the chords.
Where do you get the inspiration for your songs?
Myself.
Okay. And I?
Alright. This one's called Tonight.
Chirping tonight. Tonight, it sounds like any other night. The birds are sleeping tonight.
There.
That's a really short one, but it's simple. But I like the chords, so.
That's awesome, man. Before we end, we got a few minutes, but I still wanted to see if you wanted to acknowledge anybody. Is anybody that you want to shout out, or, you know?
Oh, yeah. Shout out to Stimpy's Revenge. I've been playing with a lot of bands lately and jamming with a lot of people.
Right.
Stimpy's Revenge is, I don't know if you guys have interviewed them before.
I don't think, no.
But they're
send them a shout out. Tell them reach out to us.
They're from Maslin, and they're like kind of a reggae rock band.
Yeah.
But I've been playing keyboards and congas and tambourine.
Oh, man, you got skill.
Yeah. Tambourine for them, like some auxiliary parts and stuff.
A tambourine on his feet. He got a baritone in one hand.
I have a whole setup, man. Like, I have a whole thing. But
octopus hands. Singing at the same time.
They're really cool. They're really awesome. They have like an alien theme going on. And every performance I wear these alien glasses, and they have all this merch, like alien merch, and they have these alien candles too. And
wow.
And one of their shows, they put the candles like on each side of the keyboard. I was like, man, this is fancy.
Right. He comes in like, ooh, they got the props set up and everything here. So Stimpy's Revenge, they out of Maslin. And who else? Anybody else? Your mom, dad, your choir singer. The teacher that you had a crush on in third grade.
My third grade teacher. My fourth grade teacher. My fifth grade teacher. Land of Panda. I still play with them. Shout outs to them. Yeah.
That's it. And where do people find you at again? Like what? Go ahead and let them know what the website is and the Facebook, whatever information that you want to.
It's just daviesquires.com. You can find my Twitter, my Instagram, my Facebook there. The Squires Show, radio show, blacksquirrelradio.com is on there too. All the all the stuff's on there.
Did I ask you about any upcoming albums or what you got coming out for your fans that's ready to hear?
Yeah, or merch too. Like, you got some merch coming out.
I've been thinking of making stickers.
With a chip and just put it on your shoulder.
Yeah, or like a pin or something like that. Yeah. But in terms of like an EP or something like that, I'm hoping to make like a keyboard and me EP.
Right.
I have a couple demos out on SoundCloud right now.
Wow. So they can go to Dave Squire SoundCloud too. They can find everything.
It's just they're just like bare bones demos. They're just recorded.
Broke it down straight butt naked.
Yeah. Oh yeah.
You can hear, just sing everything in the background.
You can hear everything.
You hear mama. You hear mama calling in the back. Baby, I told you the Christmas leaves the toilet seat there.
What are you doing in there?
Mom, I told you to wait a minute. I'm in here trying to fix the light bulb.
I'm busy.
Fix the light bulb.
Right.
Well, compared to me, when I call him probably, you know, Monday, Nat, all you're going to hear is probably...
That's it. And here he goes.
Not going to say a word. I'm just going to just do that.
That's it.
Okay.
Yeah.
I know who this is.
Wouldn't that be sweet? They said that one day there was going to be a point in life where there was going to be rap music where a person just bust out like that. We're at that point now. Because I don't know nothing about anybody saying, and I appreciate what you just brought here. That was like a breath of fresh air for me. Because I'm riding around with the volume up to 100, listening up. Bam, I'm going to kill you. When you die, I'm going to resurrect you and kill you again. After you come back to life, then I'm going to take your grandmother in there. But you come in here with something nice. It's a different sound. It's unique. You know what I mean? And, you know, just the expression in your face when you're singing. And he's serious about this. You know, he's not just up here trying to
feel it.
Yeah, like he's, you know, he's got everything's going on. The character is together, man. And that's, I guess I'm just glad that you came up here. You know, hopefully your audience get to see this.
And you came back up here. You got another dose of it.
Right. Yeah. Oh, this is my third time up here.
Is it? Yeah.
First time solo, though.
Yeah, first time solo, but third time overall.
So you family now, man. You know, you family. You come up here and put on this great performance.
So we're Olive Garden now?
Yes.
Where are the breadsticks at?
I wish I do.
I'm trying to tell you, I'm so
hungry. This has been missing for quite a few years.
Oh, man. I could eat an elephant right now.
I'm so hungry.
So we're about to, we're over the show, but we want to thank Davey Squires for coming out here and for doing this wonderful interview, you know.
Thank you, guys. Thank you, guys.
Can you just bust a couple chords just real quick?
Oh, yeah. I'll put the, here. There we go. Hold on. Let me do that.
Can you give me just a church chord? I want to bust out on the church note.
I don't know.
Like, I sit down on 22nd Street. All my family out there, thank you for watching Wild Out Wednesdays. We got David Squires, Lake Effect Radio, studio.org/studio. Signing out.
Peace.
I admit this was interesting.
That was a good ending.
Yes.